finally, it kind of reached a point where, you know, I'd written all the Rotten Ralph books, a lot of them, and a lot of other picture books. I was writing the Jack Henry series of short stories, autobiographical short stories. And I'd written the first Joey Pigza book, because I wrote that in 1998 when I was living in Albuquerque. And then that was a National Book Award finalist. And then Loses Control, Joey Pigza Loses Control was a Newbery Honor book. And I began to feel a little bit like I'd armored up some, you know, like, okay, got a few bits of recognition. And you know it's a good story. You know the whole thing with the smuggling and the high school life, living by yourself and reading books. You know that's, every writer would know that that's a juicy story to tell. And so I thought, well, it's time to tell it. And also, there had been at that time several other sort of prison books that had come out that I'd read that, you know, kind of made me sniff them out and think, you know, it's just, nah, that's not quite as authentic as I think. So I thought, why let somebody else guess at it when it's, you know, it's my story? So so then I wrote Hole in My Life, and I wrote it about as honestly as I possibly could, because being a fiction writer, even with your own life, you feel like you could improve it in a retelling. And so so I was pretty spot on with that. And then that book went out, and then that book really received its own really solid audience, you know, of teens, of adults, and, you know, the book has continued to stay alive and still gets out there. And I do a lot of speaking in high schools. I go to prisons all the time and work with young men in prisons, you know, because they have ed programs, education programs, and they have to read, so they have to read that book. And that's a good galvanizing book, you know, and then to come in and say, well, I was in your shoes, and I was in this situation, and here's what I did. And, you know, they all have to read the book in order for me to come in. And I go over it with them, and we have great discussions, incredible discussions. And, you know, you walk in and you think, oh, my God, you know, these are the guys you don't want to run into it, you know, in a dark alley with. And no, these are, like, fairly scary-looking guys sometimes. Not all of them, but some of them. And they'll look at you and go, well, how did your mom feel when you went to prison? And you're thinking, that's not the question you thought that person was going to ask you. But we realize that, you know, we're all really deeply connected emotionally, and we have so much more in common, regardless of our situations, in prison, out of prison, writing books, not writing books, that we have that commonality. And so it's great to really tap that. And, you know, and also for those guys, too, to think they have stories, they have an entry into writing as well, and with reading. And, you know, to realize and witness that on the other side, you know, on the other side of the bars, there's a life that they can go ahead and pursue. And you don't have to be defined in a small way by the mistakes you've made, that you can, you know, carry forth and then expand the definition of who you are. So with me going to prison, that's a very small chapter in my entire life. It's a good chapter. I like it, and I'm glad I did the book. But it's not the full definition of who I am. But for some of those guys, that is the definition, and now they've got to move on too, and in a positive way, I hope. So I like being part of their world. And so talking about it is now just like, oh, talking about your mom and dad and your brothers and sisters and your dogs and cats, and, oh, by the way, I went to prison. It's a great line at a cocktail party.